In this video, we're computing the moment of inertia of a thick cylindrical shell. So this cylindrical shell has an inner radius of A, an outer radius of B, and the interior is hollow, and it's rotating about its symmetry axis. Now we're told the mass of the entire thing is big M and the length is L. And we're given a strategy for how to compute the moment of inertia of this thing. We're told to break it into nested, thin cylindrical shells with a mass of dm, and then to find the moment of inertia contribution of each of those thin cylindrical shells, we use the formula for the moment of inertia of a thin cylindrical shell. That's just mr squared, and I'll post a link to the video where that formula was derived. So before we get started here, we need a quick reminder about the idea of density. So I'm going to call this volume density. This is what we use for a three-dimensional object. It's normally given the Greek letter rho, and that's just the mass divided by the volume. The units of density, just to make it a little more intuitive, are kilograms per cubic meter. And we also need to be able to turn this around. So if we know the volume of an object, we can always find its mass by taking the density multiplied by the volume. All right, so we'll set that aside and use it in a minute. Our goal right now is to express the mass of the thin cylindrical shell, dm, in terms of our variable, which is r here. R is the radius of that thin cylindrical shell mass increment. So we're going to slice and unroll this thin cylindrical shell, which creates a thin rectangular slab. And the length of that slab is still L, that's the length of the cylinder. The height of that slab, well, that corresponds to the circumference of the thin cylindrical shell before we unrolled it. And it has a radius of r, so that height is 2 pi times little r. And then the thickness of our shell, well, that's a small increment of r, that's dr. So when we find the volume of this thing, it's an infinitesimal volume, so we're going to call it dv. And that's just the product of length and width and height. And I get 2 pi rl dr. Now we're going to apply our mass formula in terms of density, and we can say the mass of the shell, dm, is equal to the density times the volume increment, dv. So multiplying rho into this expression and moving the constants out in front, I get 2 pi rho l times r dr for the mass of the thin cylindrical shell. Now we're ready to write down the moment of inertia contribution of this one thin cylindrical shell. And this is where we appeal to our previous formula for the moment of inertia of a thin cylindrical shell. It's just the mass times the radius squared. Well, the mass is dm, and then I have an r squared for the radius squared. Now we just replace dm with the expression on the line above, and I get 2 pi rho l r cubed dr. Now that we have the moment of inertia contribution written entirely in terms of a single variable, r, we can add up all the contributions by using integration. So the total moment of inertia is the sum of all the contributions. This is what an integral does. It sums all the continuously changing contributions to give you the total. And I have the integral of di. Now I can plug in di in terms of our integration variable, little r. And I have 2 pi rho l r cubed dr in that integrand. And I'm integrating from the starting value of r to the finishing value. And the smallest value of r here is a, the inner radius of the thick shell, and the finishing value is b, the outer radius. So the only variable in there is r. I'm integrating r cubed, which gives me 1/4 r to the fourth, and I can go ahead and cancel a factor of 2, so my constant out in front is 1/2. So that's just a 2/4. And then I have a pi rho l r to the fourth evaluated from little a to little b. And we can plug in the upper and lower limits there, and I end up with 1/2 pi rho l times the quantity b to the fourth minus a to the fourth. Now this is the total moment of inertia for this object, but the form of the solution isn't desirable here. We don't want to have this expressed in terms of a density. We would like to get the moment of inertia entirely in terms of the mass and dimensions of the thick cylindrical shell. So we need to eliminate that density term. And density is the mass of the whole thing divided by the volume of the whole thing. So the mass is just capital M. What's the volume of this thick cylindrical shell? Well, that's the area of the base, which is a hollowed out circle. It's a circle with a hole drilled in it, multiplied by the length L. So how do you get the area of this drilled out circle? You just take the area of the outer circle, pi b squared, that's the big circle for the base, minus the area of the inner circle that was drilled out, that's pi a squared. All right, so that pi b squared minus pi a squared, that's the area of the base of this thing. And to get the volume, we still have to multiply by the length. Now we can make this substitution back in our formula for the moment of inertia. I get a 1/2 pi times rho, and that's m. And I'll go ahead and factor a pi out of the denominator while I'm working. So m over pi times the quantity b squared minus a squared times L. Then L was the next factor in our moment of inertia, and then a b to the fourth minus a to the fourth. So a couple things cancel here. We lose a factor of pi, and a factor of L cancels as well. So I can write this as 1/2 m times b to the fourth minus a to the fourth over b squared minus a squared. And there's a really nice trick to clean this thing up. We have to recognize that b to the fourth minus a to the fourth is a difference of two squares. That's b squared squared minus a squared squared. And that always factors into a sum of those two factors multiplied by a difference of those two factors. So it factors like this. I end up with 1/2 m times b squared minus a squared times b squared plus a squared, all divided by b squared minus a squared. We get a beautiful cancellation here. B squared minus a squared is gone. And we arrive at the moment of inertia formula for a thick cylindrical shell. That's 1/2 m. And I'll go ahead and write the a term first. So times the quantity a squared plus b squared. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.